Hi, we're in the studio, but not in the Shtick studio, we're in the studio of the artist Asher Bilu. Hi, Asher.
Hello.
It's so good to be here. I haven't been here for a long time, and I've known you for over 40 years.
That's right.
And some of your work, which we're going to be looking at today, is 40 years plus old. Yeah. In fact, in the studio right now, there are two pieces. And how old's this one?
Oh, this is recent. This is last year it was exhibited in Ballarat.
Oh, this is from the Ballarat exhibition.
In a different configuration.
Right, because, I'll tell you why, because every piece is actually, pardon me, I know you don't like me doing this.
Why
but
not?
Every single piece is a separate piece, all stacked on top of each other.
Well, it's part of the big picture, and it's...
It certainly is a big picture, it's amazing.
Well, the idea is that it can be exhibited in many different configurations.
Right.
So it's a work that's made out of many components.
I tell you what, I find that your artwork is very cosmological. It really takes us into space. It gives us a new dimension on what's possible.
I'm inspired by cosmology, of course. You only have to look up, and you know what more can you hope for? So in that sense, what intrigues me about looking at the stars is what you don't see, and what we see is just a tiny fraction of what's there. And so, like in this work, there's so much that you don't see, but you feel. And Einstein himself didn't know how big the universe is, how enormous the universe is. It's almost beyond comprehension.
So, not almost, completely.
So it is completely beyond comprehension because the numbers, the weights, the distances, so it ignites the imagination. And as far as, and I love that aspect of the mystery. And so in my work, there's so much that you don't see but you feel.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's a lot of work, but what the hell, you know, that's what needs to be done. So
that's your life's work. You've been working on this. You arrived from Israel after the 1956 Sinai campaign. You just done the army, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And then you came straight into Melbourne society, literally.
Yeah, yeah.
Literally.
Yeah.
You were already an artist. You already studied art in Israel?
It was just very early beginnings. Very early beginnings. I knew that that's what I wanted to be, but it was a beginning of a long journey and into the unknown, but the feeling was there and the commitment was right there from the outset. And so that's how I started, but I've never looked back, and one thing led to another, and here I am after all these years.
Yeah, you're very prolific. I think that the amount and the depth and the width of the work that you do is extraordinary.
Often I'm asked by young people exactly the same question. You start from nothing and things grow. And what I thought was, I never imagined, you know, when I started, I will do things on such a scale. So you start small and you build up and you discover and you just go, you know, from, it's a journey. And so size does matter. and especially in my work, you know, I do big things. Because I can, and because I love the physicality of this. I want to not just look at the painting. I want to see the painting, feel the painting with the whole body.
Mm.
So it requires size, but that doesn't mean it's good.
It's also miniature as well. When you look, I mean, the overall size is large, but when you look at the intricate, tiny details, that's what I think is really mind-blowing about your work.
I think you hit the spot.
It's huge at the same time. It comes into micro. Yep.
And this is the crux of what I do. It is so much detail, in the work, and yet, which is what happens when you look at the stars. It's small, but it's so big.
Yes.
So that paradox is a natural thing. You know, looking into a microscope, a grain of sand.
Mm. Or snow. What about the snow? When you look at the molecule of water or a molecule of snow.
Well, people think abstraction, but if you look at the microscope and you look at the cell, it's abstract.
Mm.
You don't see it in real life, but it's there. If you see. So the macro micro is a big aspect of my work. Thank you for that, Henry. That's all right.
We're going to now go to a break, and we're going to enter your house. Now, your house is beyond belief, and we're going to sit in the Vincent room and talk a little bit about the other work you do, which is in art direction and sculpture.
Yes.
And installations. We haven't even touched on that yet.
Well, we haven't touched it because a big aspect of my work is... It's not so much. It's public work, you know. It's public.
Certainly is.
It's not something that an individual can accommodate in the house, you know. No. So I've done a lot of those.
And you've got a mega shtick, can I tell you?
Yeah.
I've told people I've got a big shtick. Yours is mega.
Andrew, you're getting personal here.
Okay, we'll be back after the break with more Asher Bilu. Mega shtick.